Hi, biology friends. It's Sarah, your other biology professor. Let's talk about the different names we have for DNA strands. During transcription, DNA is used as a template to make RNA. Of course, DNA is a double-stranded molecule, with the two strands being complementary and antiparallel. So, which strand do we use as the template for transcription? Well, that depends on the gene. Either way, the proteins involved in initiating transcription will identify key sequences in the promoter region of the gene and come together to get that process started. But this isn't about the proteins. This is about the DNA. So we've got our two strands of DNA, and one of those DNA strands will be the template strand. That is the strand that will be used in building our complementary RNA. And of course, remember that the template DNA strand is also complementary to the other DNA strand, the non-template. So if the template strand is complementary to the non-template DNA strand, and the template DNA strand is also complementary to the RNA that we will be producing, that means that the non-template strand and the RNA strand have the same sequence. Because the non-template DNA strand and the RNA have the same sequence, except for T's and U's, we call the non-template DNA strand the coding strand. It has the same code as the RNA that will be produced. And because the template strand of DNA is complementary to the RNA that will be produced, we call it the non-coding strand. These can also be described as the sense strand of DNA, which will have the same sequence as the RNA that will be produced, also known as the non-template strand of DNA, and the antisense DNA strand, which will be complementary to the RNA that's being produced, also known as the non-coding strand. So these are synonyms: non-template DNA, coding strand DNA, sense strand DNA, all refer to the DNA strand that is not used as the template for transcription, but will have the same sequence as the RNA that's being produced, again, except for the T's and U's. Template DNA strand, antisense DNA strand, and non-coding DNA strand are all synonyms. They all refer to the DNA strand that's used as the template and will be complementary to the RNA produced. So on problems, pay attention to the material that you're being given. If you're provided the non-template sense coding strand of DNA and asked to transcribe it, or even transcribe and then translate it, all you need to do is switch the T's in the sequence over to U's and you're good to go. It's really easy. But if you're given the template, non-coding, antisense DNA strand, you will need to go through and do some complementary base pairing there. And don't forget that the complementary sequences are going to be antiparallel. Ready to do some practice? On the screen, I've got a region of DNA and the RNA that was transcribed from it. Which strand is the coding strand of DNA, top or bottom? And which strand is the non-template strand? Pause the video if you need to think about it and hit play when you're ready to check your answer. So here, the coding strand is the DNA strand on the bottom. It has the same sequence as the RNA that was produced, except the T's in the DNA became U's in the RNA. And remember, we can also call the coding strand the sense strand or the non-template strand. So that's the bottom one as well. A little bit of practice will help you keep the term straight. Drop me a like if you learned something about sense, antisense, coding, and non-coding strands of DNA. Subscribe for more biology and check out my website for tutoring resources. I'll see you next time. Bye.